that come.
Peru, peru.
Good morning. How are you people doing? How is your world doing? I hope you guys have been doing great and amazing. How is your isolation, quarantine, you're staying at home? How has it been? Please do stay at home, stay safe, and practice the preventive measures of the COVID-19. So I guess you guys already have an idea of what I'm going to be talking about today. So guys, I'm going to give you guys the gist of what happened in my compound 2 days ago. So 2 days ago, like I have not recovered from everything. Like I'm still in shock and everything. I'm still in shock. Like I'm still not fine, really. You can see from the way I look. 2 days ago, a thief entered our compound, and me that I used to sleep. I don't even used to know. Like I sleep, I'm not like I'm a deep sleeper per se. But when I'm sleeping. I cannot be like, you know, the kind of people like you tiptoe. So except I have not slept deep, you get. So 2 days ago I was sleeping. That was around past three. So I was on my bed sleeping and I heard tifo. When I heard tifo, it was as if it was from a dream. So like I thought I was dreaming. So I just woke up and stayed still on my bed. I was still there, still low. I was still trying to, like, I was just wondering what was going on. Before I knew, I heard the voice again, tifo. That's when I realized that this shit just got real. It was really scary, and it was a lot for me because I've never been in that situation. I've never been in that situation before, so it was really a lot for me. Okay, the only thing that was coming to my mind at that point was Nigerian movie. You know, Nigerian movie, if they shout tifo, can go high. I was saying, I believe this thief never dropped it at my house. Everything was just going through my mind. Like, everything was just going through my mind. And I was just trying to look for my phone. I just tried scrap. Like, I was using my hand. I didn't want to make sound. I looked for my phone. And I checked time. Past 3. Like, seriously. Like, it hasn't got money. So when she said it, my landlord now shouted, Where you there? I said, tifo. Now they coming out. When I saw that people were already coming out, so I decided to come out too, because I'm part of the compound people. So I decided to come out, and when I came out, the thief escaped, and 2 people saw the thief, a guy. They said he was not wearing clothes. I think these days people do not wear clothes, so that, you know, it's scary. So if you want to catch them, you will not be able to catch them or something like that. So he wasn't wearing clothes. I was so scared. I could not sleep. I had to call my mother. I called my mom. Like, I could not sleep. I did not sleep till the breaking of the day. It was really scary. And up to today, I've been finding it hard to just sleep. Like, I always feel like maybe somebody is somewhere. Like, sometimes I'll just go and check my whole house to be sure if it's only me that is inside. You get this crazy. It's very crazy, really. And I feel part of the reason why people are stealing, because I've stayed here for nearly 2 years and we have not had this kind of situation before. So I feel like part of the reason why people are resorting to stealing this moment is probably because of the pandemic. They are telling people to stay at home and taking away their means of livelihood. Some of them, their families are hungry. They are hungry and they need food. So the only way is to go out and steal, which is very bad and pathetic. And I am really calling on, like, if you know somebody that knows somebody that knows somebody, you guys, like, talk to the government people. And please, see, if NEPA bill can get to every house, I'm telling you, foodstuffs can get to every house. It's not even like the one that is happening in Lagos, that people are crowding. They are saying they are protecting people from pandemic, and then people are gathering again to drag food. What if in the midst of that gathering, you go and catch something that you're not supposed to catch? You get. So I feel like the government should really do something about it. Like, it's not going to take anything. Like, all the billions of naira that prominent elite of this our society has contributed, they can use half for the medical, still use half and share food. Or even, okay, if you're not going to share food, donate a token of money to everybody's account. Yes, donate something to everybody's account. at least let's use to fend for themselves till whenever. Share foodstuffs. You cannot close everywhere like that. It's not fair. If, okay, for some days now, since like Thursday, I'll be since when. But for some days thereabout, I've been receiving message from NCDC about the virus. So if they can actually send message, it means somehow they have our details. Somehow, maybe from the network companies or from the banks, they should do something, really. It's not fair. It's really not fair, and it's totally uncalled for. I'm pleading on behalf of myself, on behalf of everybody in this country, that the government should really look into this thing. They should. Because if people go around stealing and carrying pen knives and carrying things and hurting Nigerians, so then what is the use? What exactly are we fighting for? Like, I'm feeling so sad because this thing has done a lot to my mind now, because normally I'm not this kind of person. I don't like stress. Like, if you know me, you know I don't really like stress. I don't like anything that will put me in any high jump. Right now, my heart skips and everything. It's not fair. So please, everything that needs to be put in place to help us move forward in this country should be put in place. You really can't tell people. Look, judging from my interview that I did in the other video, my previous videos, the interview I did on the street, you can see people saying that you cannot help people to stay at home when you don't make provisions for them. The least the government can do is to actually make provisions for people, for the less privileged. So that, because, okay, one of the guys I interviewed, if you notice, he said, if not in there, sick boy is going to enter the street. And that's just, can you really blame them? Yes, they are aborting lives and everything, but can you really blame them? So please, guys, please, people, if you know you have connection, please speak. We can't talk enough. So please. Thanks for watching this video. I know it's kind of sad, but then this is just how I feel right now. Oh, God. Take care of yourself. Please stay safe. Stay safe. Stay safe.